Now, the government has directed that all trade union officials who are now state officers cease holding office with immediate effect. Among those targeted are NAT Secretary General Wilson Sossion, Governor Mutahi Kahiga, and Stanley Kiptis, ODM Tom Odege, ANC Member of Parliament Omboko Milemba, and Bomet Central Member of Parliament Ronald Tunui, alongside five others. However, the Bomet Member of Parliament Tunui is serving a second term, so why now? Here's KTN's Duncan Kaimba with those details.
It is this Special Gazette Notice number 184 by Labour and Social Protection Cabinet Secretary Phyllis Kandie that will force at least 11 trade unionists to vacate office without further ado. According to the CS, being state officers as per the provisions of Article 77 and 260 of the Constitution, they cease to hold the office immediately as trade union officials in their respective trade unions. Top on the list is Nyeri Governor Edward Mutahi Kahiga, his Baringo counterpart Stanley Kiptis, KNUT Secretary General, who is ODM nominated Member of Parliament Wilson Sossion, his Nyatike counterpart Tom Odege, Bungoma Woman Representative Ford Kenya's Catherine Wambilianga, Jubilee's Bomet Central lawmaker Ronald Tonui, ANC's Emuhaya Member of Parliament Omboko Milemba, Mulei Mwaloa, John Mwamusi, Florence Bore, and Richard Cheserem. The Gazette notice comes barely a month after ODM's Wilson Sossion forced KNUT Chair Muzo Nzili, who was a Jubilee supporter, out of office, saying he was due for retirement, a move that Labour Commissioner objected, but it was in vain. Few weeks later, while addressing head teachers in Mombasa, Sem Sossion ignited a resistance against the soon-to-be-launched new education curriculum, a matter said to have rattled Education Cabinet Secretary Dr. Fred Matiang'i.
There must be consensus, there must be agreement, without which we shall organize and oppose what we have not been consulted.
Interestingly, Bomet Central Member of Parliament Ronald Tonui, now in his second term, successfully served his first term in the 11th Parliament unchallenged. Same house that had the late Kabete Member of Parliament George Mushai as a trade unionist as well. The notification to vacate office applies to all trade union officials holding either nominated or elective positions in any county assembly or parliament. The Gazette notice might, however, face a legal challenge given that Article 97 of the Constitution on membership to the National Assembly representation mandates parliamentary political parties to nominate individuals who will represent special interest groups, among them the youth, persons with disabilities, and workers. Duncan Hemba, KTN News.